Hey everybody, it's FortyWarrior. Welcome back to Ninja Gaiden Black. Last time, I embarrassed myself with Awakened Alma again. And, got through chapter 13. Now we're in chapter 14. And this is going to feature another boss. Like I said, feature another boss fight, another asshole enemy. Two asshole enemies, actually. And there's key puzzles here. You see Ghost Dooku just moving around, but unfortunately for you need keys. You need a griffin here. So, better move this way. And, well, another save point, which I clearly forgot about. And a Muramasa thing, and you're gonna probably want a Muramasa thing because, yeah, got embarrassed. That first talk thing I went through, it talks about one of those portal circle things. At the Great Bridge, if you go into that, he mentions a treasure. If you can survive that, that can grant you new life. In other words, a 60 fiend challenge with the Talisman of Rebirth as a reward. So, yeah, that's something to keep an eye on if you're interested. If not, don't worry about it. And really here, I don't think I'm going to be in any real, have any real need to burn Talisman of Rebirth. I would say that normally with the boss fight, which, if you probably figured, is Ghost Dooku. However, not recently, because I figured out a foolproof way of killing him, so. And oh yes, I forgot about this.
To the hellish depths of the Fiend Realm. The question is, can you defeat me?
How you doing, Marbus? Marbus is another greater fiend. Kind of like Dooku and the like. And he controls the underworld like Hades. Unfortunately, he doesn't have the sense of humor of, Hades from the Disney movie Hercules. I really want to switch to the True Dragon Sword because, like I said, you don't fuck with it. Well, these guys aren't too difficult. And Marvis will let me out soon enough. Yeah. There you go. And what does that give me? A reward! I know, right? Spiky chests don't really strike reward. More than, ouch, poison trap, or something like that. But we got the griffin key out of it, so... Hey, no complaints here. And if somehow you took tons of damage in that fight, well, the bats regenerate. For this chapter, the Vigorian Flail is going to be your most important item, in my opinion. I know it's crazy saying that, considering I've been saying the Dragon Sword is the best of the best and the best, and, well, that is the case, but the Vigorian Flail still is the best if you're trying to make combos or get quick attacks off. You'll see why. Those things. Those are ghost fish. And they make the bats seem like they're healing you instead of doing damage to you.
Ancient fish like shrouded phantoms. You must harness the fury of your flail to destroy them. Just remember to keep your wits about you.
What that sort of means is don't just butt mash. That's like asking to get killed. Ghost fish, they're usually coming to like 40 or 50, and they tend to come in waves. And yeah, when one grabs you, oh boy, you're in trouble. Just button mash the fuck out of your controller if that happens. Like I said, do not, under any circumstances, try... That's really when a fish can grab you, right there. If you're in that unfortunate circumstance where you just finished an attack... Alright, there's one more. Where are you, Ghosty? Ah, fuck you. I got him. If you're in that unfortunate circumstance where you just finished a combo, you have a small window where the fish can grab you. That's sort of what I mean by don't bun mash, because if you do this, there's an outstanding chance a fish is going to get you right after you finish your combo, so you got to sort of try to find out when it's a good time to stop the combo, and a good time to resume your onslaught. Thankfully, they go down in one hit. If they're a pain in the ass, you can use the Art of the Fire Wheels or even the Art of Inazuma or Ice Storm to help you out, but really, you just need to be good with the flail at this point. And you don't hit the Y button, just do all the X's. It gets the job done very effectively. And right there, you see the next locked door. A lion. So I need a key of lion to move on. Oh, did I forget to mention something? The fish regenerate. Yeah, the fish regenerate. They're dicks. Oh boy, I hate this area. Because we'll see this enemy, a super claw demon. The biggest dick of all. Oh yeah, and let's add to this by doing that. Oh yeah, and we add this. Oh, with the side of a fish. The game just says fuck you at this point. Well, at least... Yeah, if you use an Arm of Nazim or something like that, yeah, it's pretty justified. But those things have eye lasers, which sucks. They also like to, grab you. And they... You know, to coin the WWE term, they no-sell attacks. Kind of like the dragons can do at times, where they don't flinch when they're hit. And if that happens, well, yeah. Yeah. You aren't going to like the results, because you're going to be mid-combo, and they're going to grab you and fuck you up. And if you're wondering what's up here, I think there's a save point up here. I also think you need to go this way, because I don't think this game believes in wasted room, wasted energy. Jen's Diary. I have arrived in Vigor in search of the Dark Dragonblade. Lead to root my comrades. I have succeeded in infiltrating the Imperial Palace. I must accept that my comrades have all been slain, except for Dai. Yes, he must certainly still be alive. I'm sure you're starting to meet me at this moment with the key and the palace core firmly in hand. Let's drop a die as soon as possible, then plan our attack on the Emperor. February 29th, leap year! While it may be true that the Dark Dragonblade is formed out of dragon bones, one of the greatest delicacies of the ancient world, our master's plan to grind it up and use it for his herbal tea is ridiculous! Grind it up for his herbal tea? What the fuck? Of course I must tell anyone this, and therefore I must take his laughable secret. Reinforces his stench. Black Spider Clown, not bitch. Give me a moment. Okay. I definitely want content time, but it doesn't matter. He's famous for silver to mine. The Bark Spider Clan all this time has been working for herbal tea. And I've been working for a great devil elixir. Okay, now that we know that the Black Spire Clan is actually led by an incompetent lout, or an 8-year-old, or something. That's our newest door, by the way, that's the boss door. The key of the lioness is required, and there'll be ghost fish waiting around. And I think ghost fish will regen if you go into the certain zones. So, little advice, don't do it. Don't be an idiot. So our charge is get the key of the lioness. And get as many items as possible while doing it. Great Spirit Elixir could be helpful if you're ever in a bind. First thing I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to go here. I'm just going to smite enemies with the Ardent Anazuma. That's probably the MO at this point, if you figure it out, with fish and super claw demon enemies. Get back! I got him. Funny, I thought the Ardent Anazuma can kill those things. It does in mission mode. Eh, whatever. I did massive damage to it, so I'm not gonna really care at this point. Ah! Broke combo. Probably the most dangerous part is the fish that come through the walls or come from behind you, because those... Well, you're gonna be less prepared for than anybody else. Oh yeah, and the camera is a bitch. Around corners. Ooh. Remember, they come in right through the wall. No fair. And fish have a brief invincibility period when they show up. Alright, nice. Although I will say one thing about the fish, they would be the easiest 60 fiend challenges in the game if they actually allowed that. Because you know they wouldn't allow it for the bats. I mean, come on. And I got turned around, which means I'm going to be going through fish land again! Ah! Oh yeah, they give you the full compliment too. This is what happens. Even though I'm gnashing the motherfucking button as hard as humanly possible. If you want my opinion, the cremator combo just doesn't work. Because the window is actually kind of small, believe it or not, so you can't really carry out a long-ass combo. I know it seems weird because I'm getting huge combos with it before, but that is the case, because it's actually kind of a fleeting combo, if you noticed. And although it would definitely kill the fish as it came, I don't think it would do a good job. Whereas you can sort of draw out the fire pick combo. Just draw the X's a little bit. It lasts a lot longer. I suppose these fish here. Which just get annoying. Let's be honest, they're not particularly imposing. They're just annoying as all hell. Huh. Curious the fish aren't going through the wall. That didn't stop them from doing it before. That guy almost got me there. Wow, the fish are just not having fun with that corner. That's weird. Alright. Now that we did that. Key of the Lioness. There we go. At least the fish won't regenerate there. Although I'd prefer if they didn't regenerate anywhere, to be honest with you. What's through here? Probably another Spirit Elixir or something. Yep. Okay. Now that that is nearly done, we're running at around 14 and a half minutes, which doesn't bother me. And, well, I would normally stop the part if I didn't know what I was doing with the boss. Unfortunately, let go me. I am very good at this boss now. I'm actually so good at this boss fight now that I can actually take on the hard version of this. Which, well, if you do mission mode, you actually face the hard complement of Ghost Doku. Which is basically him with a bunch of fish. And I can actually beat the shit out of him. I've actually done it, so... And I haven't died. I am actually undefeated against Ghost Doku on hard difficulty, if you will. Because I figured out his number one weakness. And I figured this out completely by accident. But a lot of LPers don't know this, and a lot of people who play this game don't know this either. But the Gleam kicks his ass. And I don't mean just kicks it. I mean, it rips him a new one. And, well, you get to fight Ghost Doku here. Now, if you didn't know the strategy, you kind of have to go standard fare with Ghost Doku, except he's tougher to hit. You can use the walls and stuff to try to get some slashes in. Or just try to exploit him whenever he does that. But whenever he does that little shrug there, that is your cue to go after him. He also has that grab, which does almost nothing. Whenever he does this, BAM! Then he has that Kotetsu sword thingy that he does. You saw the charge. He has this hand thing, which... There are three ways to avoid it. There's avoid it outright. Oh, don't tell me I'm gonna destroy him this quickly! The other ways are to just slash the hand or to get grabbed and mash the button to get out of it, which really is easy to avoid. Now, why does that work? Because you saw us awaken Dalma too. And Ghost Doku has this logic too where he's allergic to the ultimate technique. Like, if you charge it up actively before they attack, they'll stop doing what they're doing and just wait. Or they'll just attack you from a distance. They stay away from it. They avoid it like it's the plague. Whenever he's charging like that, if you hold the Y button down, you can actually get an unblocked hit on him every single time. Because of that, that's why the strategy works so well. And because a Gleam does so much damage to begin with, he runs into it, he can't block it, he has no say on what to do with it. And he won't attack you during it either, which is nice. Oh, incidentally, he can grab you too, and it's the same thing. He grabs you, steals your health, life goes on. But you hate him for it. So yeah, that's the Ghost Doku fight, the quick way of taking him out. If you don't do it, you can drag the fight out for like 10 minutes. And get your ass kicked in the meantime. Anyway, the core. Doku's hate continues to slowly transform Ryu into a beast. He's got blue skin now. Feeling the blood of the fiends pounding in his veins, Ryu stands before the gates of the source of all evil, the core of the Imperial Palace. Well, now we can get out, but before we get out, the fish decide to come in. I know, right? It's not as big of a fish fight, I don't think. That might be, though, the way I'm taking him out. In the time frame? Oh, you would. Oh, go fish yourselves. This is why you don't mash the X button, guys. That shit happens too frequently. Well, at least. They gave you some really good essence, though, because there's so many of them. But anyway, here at the palace compound, our goal is to get to the... Well... Our goal is to get inside the palace, and we can't do that just yet.
Who is the Holy Vigor Emperor? A multitude of foreign powers have conspired to find out, yet none have been able to do more than scratch the surface. You must uncover the truth with your own eyes.
Interesting. so never before seen footage of the Holy Fagor Emperor. Dun dun dun. Anyway, yeah, now we're completely blue. And what does this do for us? Absolutely nothing, except make him look weirder. Maybe more badass, though, because Ryu Hayabusa in this game is a badass. Not a pansy with a 2-cent brain. Oh yeah, now they start fishing these guys in with the fight, which kind of sucks. Will you just do an attack, I ask? Fuck off. I said fuck off. Okay. That didn't work out according to plan, but I think this also carries a great something. Yep. Great double elixir. And through here would be the palace, but you need a key for that. Where's the key, you ask? Remember where I tried going up the staircase several parts ago and I didn't find what I was looking for? That was what I was hoping to find. The key for the palace. Unfortunately, it won't let you find it that early. I was about to say, give me some help, please. I don't need Nimpo. Although I appreciate the offer. Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Now, if you're really hurting at this time, you could also go back to Muramasa's, walk through town, go through that sort of thing. I'm not struggling at this point, so doing that for me is kind of just a waste. However, go through here, and nearby, you'll find a corpse. He was holding a key of the decayed soul, and Dai's diary. As a member of the Black Spire Clan, he must fulfill his mission for herbal tea, and gain the respect of the clan leader. He's been badly wounded, but he obtained the key to the core. And unfortunately, February 29th, the leap year, with the last bit of strength in him, he made it this far, but he can't pass through the door, huh? Interesting. So all the Black Spire ninjas have fallen, leaving just Ryu Hayabusa, the only ninja. Oh, and Ayane, who... yup, just basically is a spy. Nothing more, nothing less. Let's be honest here. Man, I wish they had an armlet that would actually give me health. Oh, I got full health now, but it would be nice to actually get an armlet that would do that. That'd be amazing. Okay, that was simple. The fish will always regenerate, but I don't think the claw demons do, thankfully. Actually, the claw demons, I would actually use the Dabalara with. The big ones? I would use the Dabalara against them, not the true dragon sword. Like I said, I like it, but for some reason, I seem to get better hard-hitting combos with the Dabalara. And they actually seem to flinch when you hit them more often with it than you would with the Dragon Sword. So because, not because the sword itself, but because of the combos you do with the sword. It's complicated, I know. Anyway, we're at the core. There's only one place to go. Inside. So, that's what we'll do next time. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.